Hey guys, and welcome to the final chapter, chapter 5 of Life is Strange, True Colors. Again, thank you guys so much for watching these playthroughs. I really, really hope you've been enjoying them, and I hope you enjoy the final chapter. Okay, we're going in, okay. All right. Side B. Oh, I need to turn my, oh no. I gotta turn my lights off. They're seeping through. Get out of here. Wait.
Welcome back, Alex.
What is this?
Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado?
Wait, what?
Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
I don't like Dr. Lin, dude. The meaning of home, not to be afraid of my emotions.
I learned to let myself feel, I guess. And to not be afraid of those feelings. Couldn't one argue that those old fears turned out to be justified? What do you make of that friction? I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery.
I don't like it.
Got to kiss a pretty girl. But Alex, you're right back where you started.
You're wrong, Dr. Lin, you stinker. You stink, you smell. You're wrong.
You're wrong.
Yeah.
I don't belong in here.
Nope.
If that were true, Alex, you'd know you were talking to an empty chair.
I knew that was weird. Okay. I think this is like she's in some weird dream world from her fall.
What the fuck?
Because she fell. I think she's like laying down in the mines right now. God, it's so pretty, guys.
Is that what I look like? Really?
Aw.
Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock.
So interesting. What?
Alex Chen. My guitar case has never heard of me. Sure.
Aww. She's going through something. Huh. Oh my gosh, I totally forgot to record. Clay, you're recording, right? I totally forgot to record. Oh no, Clay, you've been recording? Oh no, I totally forgot. Yep, recording. Okay, good. I was so nervous to play. Thank you, Clay. Clay to the save. I just was like, realized. I was like, oh no. I've just been so excited to play. Oh, wait, what am I gonna find a code?
I guess that's me. Case number 53322.
Should I start over from the beginning just in case? I didn't realize I wasn't recording. Okay, I'm just gonna restart just because I'm scared. I'm just gonna restart real quick, okay? Just in case the recordings don't work. Okay. Yes. Okay. Sorry again, guys. All right. Yay, we're getting into chapter 5. Let's go. All right, there we go. This is definitely the first time we've played this beginning portion of chapter 5.
Welcome
Never
back,
seen it.
Alex. Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado? Let's start with something positive.
She's in a mind loop.
What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
I'm just going to go with what I did before. Okay.
I learned to let myself feel, I guess. And to not be afraid of those feelings. Couldn't one argue that those old fears turned out to be justified?
I like Dr. Lin's voice, though, even though
what
I don't like Dr. Lin.
What do you make of that friction?
I don't like it.
I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery.
Yeah, I don't like
kiss
it.
A pretty girl.
I don't like Dr. Lin.
But Alex, you're right back where you started.
You're wrong, Dr. Lin. You still stink.
You're wrong. I don't belong in here.
If that were true, Alex, you'd know you were talking to an empty chair.
All right, guys. We, I still think
what
that she's
fuck?
In some like dream world because she's laying in the mine right now.
Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock.
Maybe the like the sound she heard or whatever were people like trying to get to her or something. I don't know.
Alex Chen. My guitar case has never heard of me. Sure.
Oh, wait, it was like, I'm gonna go look at it again. For those of you who are watching this on YouTube, I actually started playing the game without recording. And, so I played like the first like 2 minutes or something. Up until like this point. He was like 5-3-3.
I guess that's me.
5-3-3-2-2.
This number 5-3-3-2-2.
We're only just a number, huh? Stinky Dr. Lin. Stinky Dr. Lin.
No.
I'm sorry. I like that it wasn't hard to find the code. Usually it's so hard to find the code. It was just right there. I appreciated that. Boom! Let's go! Is it... Oh, it is... Okay. Is it gonna sound like crap or something? I like the dog picture in the back. Oh. I guess she's not gonna play it. Oh, I am gonna play it.
The hell? Can't play if I can't tune.
Wait, what?
Who steals a single tuning peg?
Oh. I love that shot. It is so pretty. Like the bokeh.
Is that what I look like? Really?
I love all these shots. The cinematic's so pretty.
These don't belong to Dr. Lin.
Huh. Wait.
Tuning peg.
This is so eerie and cool. This is so cool. Cool. Okay. There's a tape recorder. Uh-oh. Dude, I was so shocked yesterday. Like, I knew that Jed was not good. Like, I knew he was not a good guy. That's all I knew. Like, just from working on the game, I knew that Jed was not a good guy. But I don't know anything else, so I am excited to learn more. But man, I still was even shocked with what happened. Emotional instability, occasionally violent outburst, hallucinations, visual hallucinations, oral, delusional, ideation, depression, anxiety. Jesus. Jesus. Okay, so I guess I should go. No, I'm gonna tune my guitar. I think I could have played it without tuning it, it looked like. Hopefully it sounds pretty still. Oops. Nope. Not good. Not good. Oh God, oh no. Oh no, 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 no. Baby. Oh, it looks so good though. Oh, I'm starting to get all cryy. I'm gonna start crying now. Oh shit, I cannot believe she's not dead though. Seriously, that fall. I'm pretty sure Jed thinks that he killed her. Wow. She's stuck? She's stuck on a beam?
Oh.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Holy shit, dudes. Wow. Oh my God. Oh, this is so sad. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. No, she kept falling. No, 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 no. She fell again? Is she gonna go? What? She fell again? She back in her dream world? No. This is not good. She's fallen too much. Oh my God. Yeah!
Gabe?
Aww. Gabe!
You're dead.
So? Lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
I want to say a hospital.
Dr. Mendez to intensive care. Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick, so is our father. But it's a different kind of sickness. Play your part.
What?
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Oh, shit.
Behave.
Oh shit, they're in the hospital for their mom. Oh god, no.
Alex, go check on your mother.
Oh god.
Okay. She was right over there, waiting for me. Mom used to fidget with her keys whenever she was worried.
Oh no. I already feel tears coming on. I don't want to.
Gabe, Alex, I need you to listen very carefully. We got some scary news today. And I'm going to be spending some time at the hospital.
What? Ugh. Mom, are you okay?
Hush now. It's going to be okay. Do you understand me? Things will be different for a little while. But I am going to be okay.
We spent so much time in here that I basically memorized every article. Gabe told me it was full of needles. It scared me to death.
Oh my gosh. So... the mom, I guess we'll find out, but it seems like the mom passed away, and then the dad was just unfit to take care of the kids, or...
we couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. There it is. The painting that taught me that art sucked sometimes.
Ew. The mining picture.
Gabe and I used to watch cartoons on this thing after school. She knew. Even then, she knew. It was always too hot in this room.
Oh, I don't want to do it. Oh, I don't want to do it. Okay.
She's just on the other side.
Of cancer. I'm already getting choked up, guys. Oh, God.
How many nights did Dad spend in this room? Sleeping in an uncomfortable chair and eating vending machine dinners.
Thank you guys again so much for being here. If you do exclamation immersive play, it'll tell you about what's happening in this stream. I'll be taking a break in probably an hour or so, and we'll probably spend an hour chatting with everybody in the stream and in the chat and talking about everything. But until then, I will be focused on the game and what's going on. And yeah, I thank you guys so much for being here, though.
There's something so weird and scary about watching your dad cry.
Oh, I don't know.
Mom. Every time I saw her, I worried it would be the last.
Ah.
Hi, Mom.
Oh.
Mom. Mom.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that how it went? You don't think you missed anything?
Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay.
Wait, I should probably... Wait, hold on.
Wait. Did I...
When missing patient answers to Alex, she was always scratching at the door trying to get out, and she declawed, so her capacity to fend for herself is minimal. If spotted, please exercise caution when approaching. She will appear friendly and normal, but we've had some behavioral issues in the past. Please help me find my patient. I'm starting to get really worried. Attention residents, please join me in welcoming Alex Chen back to Helping Hands. We're happy, though not surprised, but Alex has once more submitted herself to this soul-defying and inescapable embrace of our institution. In light of all recent excitement, now is a good time to remind Helping Hands residents that impulse to leave our institution, while understandable, are best resisted. Remember, the outside world is a sharp tooth and possessed of an insatiable hunger, and you are soft and slow and appetizing. Why throw yourself into the mouth? Throw yourself instead into mine. Fuck, Dr. Lin. Dude, I have, like, tears, like, in my eyes still because I'm just, like, here. Like, fuck. Okay. Today we went back to the hospital because my mom is sick. Our neighbor drove us there because my dad stayed the night with my mom. I wanted to bring my rat Shushu because I always bring Shushu when I go to the hospital. Oh, sorry, guys. See my mom, but I forgot. Mom says I have to take care of my brother and my dad. She used to not be as skinny, but now she is so skinny. I wish she was not so skinny, and I wish she could come home. She gave me a necklace she wears sometimes. Aw. Bless her heart. I think I was too young to really understand what she was telling us. I knew that sick people went to the hospital, and I didn't want my mom to be sick. That was the extent of it. Damn it. She knew she was dying. Even as she told us that everything was okay, she was thinking about how many seconds she had left with us. She needed us to believe things would be okay. She wanted to give that to us. A month, maybe two, maybe six or seven, where we could just love our mom without ever wondering when she'd be gone. She did it for us. Ugh. But God damn it, I wish she hadn't. Maybe if I'd known, I would have soaked more of her up, kept more of my memories of her safe.
I miss something. We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. No matter how much Mom drank, her throat was always dry. Hi, Mom.
I can't handle the slow head turn, dude. It, like, fucking chokes me up.
Mom. Mom.
Water, Alex. Get her some water.
Thank you.
Thank you. You almost never cried, even when you were very small. Did you know that? That's been my biggest challenge with you. How do you take care of someone who is already so strong?
Oh, it's the necklace.
No tears, my strong girl. I want you to make me a promise. Your brother, your father, they are going to need you. You have to be strong.
Oh.
Will you do that, Alex? Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
No, really? Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, that was so sad. Oh, fuck. My face is just drenched in my tears. Oh, we're in their house. Wow. Shushu. I'm just gonna keep crying. I keep crying.
Was that the last time you talked to her? Mom.
I think so.
Do you miss her?
Gabe, what's going on?
You're 11, I'm almost 15. Dad and I are time bombs. You keep running back and forth, trying to defuse us both.
Oh gosh.
This is going to suck so bad. Play your part.
Oh.
was only ever one thing to do when they got like this. Drown them out. Wait for it to pass.
Just me. But you know that's not how it went down, right?
Oh, gosh. So bad for Alex. So bad.
It was my job to keep the peace. But no matter what I did, at least I managed to hold on to you, Shushu. The killer mistress tabs in this book weren't even close to right. Gabe loved Son of Lead back when it was an indie. It was too gory for me.
Thank you guys so much again for being here. I appreciate it.
Gabe had barely used this backpack in weeks. Nobody could get him to go to school. Mom and Dad had this TV before they had either of us.
Oh. The tangerines.
I tried so hard to keep my promise to her.
Oh.
Dad's laundry. I always set it here when it was done so he could find it. Cleaning Dad's ashtray was not my favorite job in the world. It was full of greeting cards. Mom kept every single one we ever got. Thanks for trying, Lucky Cat.
My job was to sort them in order of how close we were to a collections notice.
I wanted to be a werewolf that Halloween. Couldn't afford the costume. I can't believe they were ever this happy.
Hey, Gabe. I'm Leslie Halloran. I'm from the Oregon State Child Protective Services. We got a call from someone who said there might have been some kind of fight here last night. Is your dad home?
Oh, gosh. You know what? We were... that was like, rehearsal. And I'm in this play at school. And my dad, like, he was, helping me learn my lines.
Must be some play. But if you need anything... My number is on there, okay?
Almost empty.
I've missed so many memories too, and I'm very upset about that. I'm like really upset how many memories I've missed. I tried to explore so much and I still miss so many things. After this, CPS became the name we called the boogeyman. Watch out or CPS will come. Be nice and quiet or you'll get swallowed up by CPS. Don't fight with Dad, Gabe, please. Do you want another CPS visit? It was the swinging pendulum dangling over the pit we were in. Gabe especially was terrified of them for the usual reasons. Who wants to be a ward of the state? But also because despite everything, the idea of losing Dad when we'd already lost Mom made him feel like he couldn't breathe. I think Gabe always hoped that Dad would come around. He had to, right? Eventually. And if he didn't, if we got piled into a town car and driven away from him forever, what else did Gabe have to hope for? This, like, makes it even more... Oh, I'm gonna cry this entire episode, guys. Oh, my God. This makes it even sad, more sad, because, like, he was trying to fight his dad. You know? Like, just from the first episode with the wall kick, like, he was trying to find him. He never wanted to lose him, it seems like.
Almost always. Two cups water for one cup rice. Set timer for 30 minutes. Do your history homework. Serve.
Oh my gosh, guys. Yeah, it's,
We never really touched these after Mom died. She was such a good cook. Gabe used to steal Dad's beer all the time. It was like the one thing they didn't fight about. Mom's old sewing kit. Don't think I've ever even tasted a butter cookie.
I know I could open the door, but also I want to just see if I can, what this does if I listen to it again. Am I just going to listen to the song? What a great song choice again. Oh, we're just going to sit here and chill. I'm cool to sit here and chill because this game's got me fucked right now. Thank you guys again so much for being here. I'm not chilling, I'm crying more. How do they pick the song so well? This is not a Zen moment. God damn, guys. Oh.
All right. When wasn't this place falling apart?
I don't want to go out here, dude.
Gabe and Dad were so loud when they fought.
Jesus. Where are you going? Are you gonna tell her? Or is that my job?
Keep your voice down.
Fine, I'll do it. Alex, Dad lost his job again. So we're broke again.
Don't talk to me that way. Despite what you may believe, you do not know everything. You think what? I laid myself off?
It's okay. We'll figure it out. I could,
I don't know, Dad. But what are we supposed to do now? We gotta eat?
We can sell some records. Or what about my guitar? We could sell that?
Alex, What is it gonna take to get you to stop defending him?
If your mother could see you now.
I don't want to hear about Mom.
Babe!
I'm so tired of you using her as an excuse to be a piece of shit. Don't fucking touch me, piece of shit!
Dad. Oh, shit.
Damn it. Alex.
I'm okay. It's okay. It was an accident.
Alex, I didn't...
Dad. Dad, it's okay. Really. I'm not hurt.
He's just such a broken man.
I can't do this.
Oh, no. He left.
Dad.
He fucking left. He just left them like that?
Someone will come. That woman from CPS.
He just left them like that? Oh, God. He just left him just like that.
Dad.
No fucking way.
I'm sorry.
No. Dad!
Oh, yo, I can't, this is insane. Okay, I gotta take a freaking break. Guys, I'm just like a mess right now. I'm like I am an ugly crier. Look at me. I'm such an ugly crier. I can't, I gotta just like get some tissues or something. Jesus Christ. Like, actually, I need to get some tissues. I am an ugly crier. I need to get some. How, like, yo, you know how, like, your emotions just get tapped in, and then you're just, like, man, and you're super sad, and you just haven't, like, you just, woo, wow. If you've never been in my stream before, I'm very vulnerable. Ooh. But you know, like, when, like, something makes you sad, and then it just unlocks this, like, untapped space that you haven't tapped in for a little bit, and then you just can't stop crying. Yeah. This kind of fucked me up real quick. I'm sorry, guys. Like, obviously, like, I've never dealt with something like this, but it just makes me miss my fucking family, you know? Because I haven't seen them in, like, 2 years because of the pandemic, and it's just, like... This really makes me sad. And, like, like, obviously, like, if I was playing this, like, alone, not on stream, like, I could just cry and just, like... cover myself in my blankets, but I'm live on stream, and I can't do that. I'm, like, all sweaty and hot. Yeah, this is a really rough scene, guys. I don't know if I'll be able to play this without crying. Oh, man, dude. Yeah, Erica did an amazing job, dude. She just, like, her performance, like that last shriek of her like dad leaving, like just fucking sent me over the edge. Oh. No, I know it is. It's okay to cry, and that's why I'm still sitting here just crying in front of you guys. But yeah, I don't know. I'm still alive. I can't walk away and just like, yeah, bury myself in a blanket because like I'm alive. But yeah, I don't know. I guess it just hit. It just hit. Yeah, it's just like, yeah, you could just, like, you've been sad or stressed or, you know, just things are not going right or something. But, like, you know, you don't ever explore the emotion, you know, and then something happens. Like, you're playing Life is Strange, Chapter 5, and it just taps into your emotions. And then all of a sudden, you're just sad and you're feeling all those emotions you didn't tap into before. And that's kind of what's happening right now, I think. Yeah. I would love a hug. I haven't had a hug in so long. I'd love a hug. Thank you, guys. I appreciate you guys. I look like such a fucking mess right now. Look at my eye. They look like they're just, look at me. Look at my fucking eyeball. It's red. My eyes are really red. My tissue is just not tissue anymore. It's just wet tissue. Ugh, Kit. It sucks, huh? Yeah, I've just been, like, super paranoid about the pandemic. And, you know, I've just kind of isolated myself. Kind of isolated myself away from, like, literally everyone because I'm just so nervous and scared and, you know. And yeah, so I haven't been around too many people. Thank you guys so much. I really appreciate you all. Thank you so much for the donation, Billy. I appreciate that. I'll go through the notifications here in a little bit, guys. Properly thank everybody for the follows and the donations and everything. I really do appreciate you all. You guys don't realize. I know we have a lot of new people here in the community, and for the new people that have come into the community recently, like, this community means the fucking world to me. You guys literally mean the world to me. And if you just joined the community today or 3 days ago or 2 years ago, like, you mean the world to me. And I just feel so thankful that I've had y'all for the last couple years. During the pandemic when, you know, a lot of shit's happened and we can all keep each other company. It's a really great community. I feel so grateful. So grateful. I think about it every day. Oh, gorillas. Oh, I did not expect for this to happen. I had no idea. I should have some water. You're right, Karen. Thank you. Yeah, I need to clean my sinuses out for sure. What's up, Reason? Thank you guys so much for all the kind words. I really appreciate it. Oh, Angie. Oh, you guys are so kind. Thank you. Yeah, we're not even like halfway into the game, the chapter, and I'm just like, I had to stop, man. I had to stop. That was just so intense. It was so intense. Ooh. I don't know, Roman. And I want to play this multiple times, dude. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get through this scene or this chapter multiple times. Probably, Papa. Oh, Wes. You guys are seriously so kind. I know, Tati. I know. That's why I'm just allowing myself to just be. You guys have allowed me to be. I think being vulnerable is very important because it just allows you to feel. And I think a lot of us just kind of, and even I do, obviously, like, you know, just recently said it, you know, I've been kind of like keeping a lot of stuff just in and just kind of keeping forward. But like, yeah, a lot of us just try and bury stuff sometimes and we don't feel things, and especially in front of other people. And I think that it's really important to be vulnerable because you learn a lot about yourself, you know? And so I'm just, yeah, I don't know. It's good for me to be vulnerable. And hopefully it inspires others to also be in touch with their emotions around other people. And just with themselves. I think some of us don't let ourselves cry. And it's okay. It's okay to cry. It's okay to not be okay. Uh-huh, Maya, I'm so happy to hear that. Oh. Graham, my heart, dude. Andrew, thank you guys. I appreciate that, Timon. My eyes, my tears are liquid diamonds. Well, then I'm fucking rich because I just cried a lot. Oh, Medusa. Katy was the best bag carrier had at $6. Aw, thank you, Billy. I appreciate that. Oh my gosh, you guys, we've been getting a lot of donations. I should go through and I'm gonna thank people now because a lot of people have followed and donated, and I know it takes me a bit to thank people, but I just really want to thank people right now. So let me go ahead and do that. Let me go back a little bit. Cam. Aw, Frozen Druid. Thank you so much for that subscription with your Twitch Prime. Melody, thank you so much for that follow. Unicorn for the bitty bits. Zan, thank you so much for the follow. Oh, Alex! Alex, I don't know if you're still here. Thank you so much for that subscription. I'm so sorry that I was immersed in the playthrough. Thank you so much. It was so fun hanging out in your stream yesterday. Thank you so much for that subscription. Lampshade, thank you for the follow. Pitchy, Iron, thank you so much for the follows. Dex Polio, thank you so much for the 1,026 bits. I really appreciate that. You're like the true MVP of the next gen and is life next gen Life is Strange gaming characters, specifically Steph. Oh, I'm glad that you like Steph so much. That makes me happy. Thank you so much for the bitty bits. Andros, Io, Astro, Mal, thank you guys so much for the follows. Maria, thank you so much for the subscription with your Twitch Prime. Lurking to avoid spoilers, yes. Don't get spoiled with the ending here. Thank you so much for that resub. And Little Spacehead, thank you so much for that subscription. I eat cake. I had love cake right now. Thank you so much for that follow. Little Spacehead, thank you so much for the bitty bits. Ricky, White Wolf, Odd. Oh my gosh, there's so many guys. I'm so sorry for missing these. Nan, Brun, thank you so much for the follows. Papa Shasta, thank you so much for the donation. Appreciate that. Unicorn, thank you so much for the bits again. Billy, again, for the $20 donation. Thank you so much. And the biggest virtual hug. I appreciate that so much. Sleepy, thank you so much for the follow. Little Spacehead, thank you so much for the $5 donation. White Wolf, thank you so much for using your Twitch Prime to subscribe. SFM, thank you so much for the follow. Maria, thank you so much for the 355 bits. I appreciate that. Fallen, thank you so much for the $10 donation. Oh my gosh, you guys are being so kind. Thank you guys so much. Never be sorry for being you. You're so amazing in everything you do. I really wish I could hug you. And don't worry, I understand the fear of everything right now. Final note, no such thing as an ugly crier. Dude, I look high. I look like I've just smoked so much pot. Kata, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate that. Thank you guys so much. Oh, you guys don't really understand how much I appreciate you. Like, I don't know, dude. Like, what the heck is happening right now? You guys are so kind. Thank you guys. I just really appreciate you all. And so many, like, just so many different people. I just appreciate you all. And I like to make it known that, you know, I appreciate you no matter what. You know, if you're lurking and or you're chatting, or, you know, you're gifting subs, I appreciate you no matter what. No matter what, I appreciate however you enjoy watching the stream. And yeah, I just appreciate you guys so much. I love the lurkers. You guys are awesome. Everybody's awesome. Weasel Boy, thank you so much for gifting us up to Fortune, Casu, Jazz, Blizz, and Aqua. We're already in a level 5. We've left the station. Oh my gosh, you guys. Okay, we're jumping back in, guys. Oh, all right, let's go. Let's go. Back to the immersive playthrough. Again, guys, thank you. Thank you so much. Whew. She's still in her dream world, it looks like. Oh, she's got Shushu. I feel like I'm just gonna cry more.
Hey, can I ask you a question? Which orphanage is this? The one in Grant Park? Kind of thought it'd be nicer.
I can't do this, okay? I can't.
You need to.
No.
You need to be honest about what you see.
I was. I have. And now I'm done.
Almost. But not yet. You are 12. I am 16. I steal a car and end up in juvie.
Gabe, come on.
Then you're 13, 14, 15. Orphanages, group homes, musty rooms in the strange houses of foster parents. By the time you're 17,
you've seen them all. Somewhere along the line, you start to feel things. Your own emotions don't belong to you.
Oh, cool.
You have nothing. No one. You are alone.
Oh, I thought he was going to explain the emotion thing.
I don't want this.
Alex. Play your part.
Damn, this whole chapter, man. Holy shit.
Play my part. We weren't allowed to bring glass into the dorms, so we had to drink from this thing.
Like hamsters in a cage.
Except if...
It's locked.
Must be after curfew. We're not going anywhere. God. They put me on so many meds.
Wow.
Did any of them ever work?
Some of them helped. A little. None of them fixed me.
In their defense, mutant empathy isn't exactly in the DSM.
They used to say this place wasn't a prison.
Well, maybe they were trying to keep you safe.
Guess so. Whatever the reason, the end result was prison bars.
The music, dude.
I took a fork in here one time and hid it under my mattress. Just cause, fuck you.
Music's just getting louder.
They should have stenciled the same thing on all of us.
Do you really feel like you were their property?
We didn't belong to anyone else, did we? I remember the kid who put this here. Sadie? Sally. Something with an S?
That's so sad.
You were friends at first, right?
Way at first. Then I freaked out on her and she was done with me. Just like everyone else.
Fancy.
Everyone had one good outfit. We wore them to meet the parents.
Did it help?
Kinda think you already know the answer to that question. I used to write one every day. Stupid.
My God.
Why? You clearly missed him.
And I thought he missed me. Hence, stupid.
I still can't believe, like, obviously I've never been in that position of that the dad was in, but like, just to literally leave in the middle of the night in front of your kids and say, CPS will find you. He obviously was just going off of his emotion, but like, but it's just like, what? It just makes you think, like, does that happen? You know, like, does that literally happen to parents? And it does. Parents just abandon their kids. Maybe not as blunt as that, but they do. And it's just so fucking sad. And, like, I want to feel bad for the dad because obviously, like, he couldn't do it. He couldn't do it. He couldn't do it. He could not take care of the two kids without the mom. And, like, he lost... obviously the love of his life, you know, she said, you know, they were so happy. So it's just like, I don't know, like, I don't want to be mad. I don't want to be mad, but it's just like, how can you not be when you just literally left your kids and said the lines, CPS will find you probably. I think that's what really made me upset. Like, you can't do that. I don't know, like, when you have a kid, I don't have a kid, but when you have a kid, you are now living for that human being until they turn 18. Like, they are your job, they are your responsibility, you know, until they're an adult.
If I want to get out of here, I've got to play my part.
I think that even past adulthood, you know, past being 18, like, you know, they're still your kid, and you know, you're still their parent. But like, yeah, once you have a kid, like, you've taken on that responsibility, and you're no longer, you know, living necessarily for yourself. Like, this is your responsibility. And to be able to, like, I mean, you, that's so horrible that he just left the kids. I agree, Cassia. I agree. It's just, like, you feel bad for him because obviously, like, he was in a really bad place as well, and, like, he couldn't do it. But, like, I think he could have tried harder as well. I know he said something like, think of what your mom would think of you now, Gabe. And I'm just like, when he left, I'm like, think about what your wife would think of you now leaving her fucking kids. What? You can't say that to Gabe and then just leave your kids. Damn. I mean, like, think about Charlotte and Ethan. Like, Charlotte's dealing with a shit ton of stuff, right? And we even heard Charlotte say that she hates Ethan, which was very hard to hear because she obviously doesn't want to feel those things. But Charlotte didn't just leave Ethan. Like, Charlotte didn't walk away from that. You know what I mean? I think that's a really good juxtaposition of showcasing.
I guess I've like to take a seat.
Two different.
Face the music.
Two different parenting styles in the same kind of, not same kind of situation, but in, you know, trauma within the family, and one parent walking away, one parent staying, which is interesting to think about. This game is really good, and it makes you think a lot, and I think that's what's really great about these games, and this game is so fucking good. Okay.
How you holding up, Shu?
Can't believe how long you've had that thing.
That thing was my only friend after you left. Guess I missed a few days.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I don't think anything was told about her sending him to his dad. I think they just have it. To me, personally, as my playthrough, it sounded as if it was just his time to go see his dad. But maybe, I don't know. Okay, so we saw all this stuff.
I don't understand. Why can't I have my guitar?
We've been over this, Alex. Your guitar stays in the rec room. You can play it during free time.
Damn, why are you being mad?
That's bullshit. I don't need it in the fucking rec room. I need it when I'm stuck in the fucking dorms.
Alex, that's enough. Maybe we'll just take away your guitar privileges entirely, if that's what you prefer.
Oh my god.
You can't do that!
Wow. Making sure I'm not missing anything else.
Everyone's feelings were so loud. I just needed something to distract me.
Okay. Oh God, what's happening? What is happening? Remember to keep everyone happy. Oh, this was her fear before the dad left. To do homework, English, history, math, health, vacuum, dust off surface, organize bills, call pharmacy, dad's blood pressure meds, break time, listen to records, 5 minutes, no more, Gabe's laundry start, make rice, chop veggies, cook chicken, throw veggies into pan with chicken, serve, Gabe's laundry, washer, dryer, dad's laundry start. Replay life as an orphan. They didn't get it. I wasn't just being a brat, and I wasn't acting out for attention. The guitar was fucking sacred to me. The only thing I could do to keep myself from losing it in the dorms every night, especially as I got older and my whole thing with emotions got worse. But they didn't see that. They saw a little psycho glaring daggers, making demands. I think that's why they wanted to see. I think that's what they wanted to see. I had forgotten how difficult the dorms were at night. We all had nightmares. Hard to live the sort of life that lands you in an orphanage without going through some pretty nightmarish stuff. But the difference was, I had everyone else's nightmares. I just needed to hold my guitar, to press my fingers against the strings, feel the vibration in my belly. That was the only way I could get back to sleep. Wow. Still so sad I missed memories.
She's been through so much.
Oh, it's the different parents.
We're prepared for a troubled girl.
Seriously, like, bless any person who, like, I mean, I don't know, the chances are that somebody is watching has been in a family who's fostered a child or has been a foster parent themselves, but oh my gosh, like that's, you guys are something out of this world to take in, you know, a kid, and foster them.
It says here she's sensitive. What does that mean?
I wonder why she's never found a home before. I'm sure she's a sweet girl, but she's not for us.
She's awfully old, isn't she?
This is the kid that's been in all those fights, right?
I want to help. I really do, but there's just something...
off.
Broken. Wrong.
With her.
Sorry.
Why?
You need to see it.
See what? That nobody picked me?
Nobody picked you. Nobody picked you. Nobody wanted you.
Damn, dude.
Mom died.
Her subconscious is so fucked.
I bailed. You couldn't keep us together.
It was my job to keep us...
You were 11 years old. You were 11 years old. You were a kid, Alex. Let it go. People leave. Life gets hard. Sometimes it's a big shit sandwich.
make it better. Be angry at Dad. Miss Mom. Hell, be angry at me. But don't give up. No one gets to tell you what you're worth. And no one can take your life away. Fight.
I'm not sure I...
You have a gift. It's something you don't even understand. You can change the world. Make it better.
This scene is amazing. This scene is so amazing.
What?
Get up and fight.
Back in the freaking mine now, huh? Jesus. I can't believe how far she fell. I know she had two different falls, but like, that's still a really big fall. And she's probably broken some bones. Yes. Yes. Now that's fucking cool. That's awesome. I like that. So, you may not grab. I think you always grab the mat, I guess. Dude, how is she gonna stand up? No way, dude. You've got like broken. You've broken your legs. No way, man. You got this. Dude, I'd be so scared down there. Also, too, like, could they just do another blast? Man. No way. No way she can walk out of here, dude. She. I like that she kept it. And it says never give up on the, I don't know if you guys remember, but yeah, it says never give up on the little match thing. And it was like a reminder to him, I guess. And then
I've got to find a way out of here.
No way. This hurts me. Like her walking hurts me.
No more ladder. Not that I'd be much good at climbing.
We fell so freaking far. Like, I feel bad walking with her. Like, I feel so bad. Because she's hurting, and I'm the one that's walking with her. Ooh.
Mines growing into mines. Just like Jed said.
Dude, this is sketch, dude. Oh.
I'm gonna choose not to read anything into this. I could almost laugh if it wouldn't hurt so much.
I cannot believe she's not dead. That's just... Wow.
How long has this stuff been down here?
Years. God, it's so pretty, though. It's just, of course, it's beautiful. Dude, I'd be freaking... I don't like this. I don't like anything.
No. No, 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 no. No. Come on, no. No. No, no.
It's just dark.
I can do this. I can do this.
Oh. Oh.
That aura is the only lead I've got.
God, the freaking sounds. They're so good. Oh, it's just like giving me chills. We're about to see some just bad shit down here. Oh, God.
All right, boys, getting close.
Held average for life, huh, Jed?
Dig so deep, we see where the devil sleeps.
Goddamn right.
This is it. This is what Typhon tried to bury.
A lot of runoff moisture in this soil. Jed, we gotta call it. This dig is fucked.
Nothing's fucked.
Jed, we got no pumps running. No.
My teams have never quit a dig this deep before. We finish the job.
Ooh.
Steady goes. Steady.
Fuck was...
Move! Come on! Clear the tunnel! Who's on radio?
Jed! Fuck! Jed! Jed!
Oh my God.
We gotta move! Now! There's still men back there! They'll drown!
Yeah, and so will we if we don't get the fuck out! Make the call, Jed!
God damn it! God damn it! Everyone, let's go! Now!
Smells like fireworks. Must be where Typhon blew the charges.
So they dug too deep and then it filled with water? Damn. Oh shit.
Dad.
Wait, how did this get here? Wait a second!
Jed! Come back! Jed, you son of a bitch!
Jed, you gotta stop, man.
Jed! Fuck you, Jed! Come back!
It's over, Jed. He's not coming back.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I just have to pause again. Holy shit. Holy shit. There were records of him coming to this town, and that's why Gabe went to this town, was to find him. Does that mean the entire fucking town knows that the dad was here and knew of the dad and who the dad was? Jed obviously did. Oh, I'm pissed right now. I am pissed right now. Yeah, no. Yeah, the dad came to the town. Because there was records of him coming to Haven Springs. That's why Gabe came to Haven Springs. Oh my gosh. I'm trying not to look at chat in case there's spoilers in there. But that's crazy. So Jed obviously knows and then knew of Gabe coming into the town and was like, we just gotta keep this all clean. Fuck, dude. Oh my God, I think he actually literally killed Gabe. Oh no. Maybe he was close to figuring something out. Oh fuck, this is so fucked. I was like, wait a second. why is that necklace there? Because remember we saw Alex chuck the necklace at him before he left and he took the necklace. And I was like, why is this in the mine? And then it just suddenly occurred to me that holy fucking shit. Her dad was one of the miners. Wow, dude. Who died? Her dad was one of the miners that died. And, oh, I'm going to start crying again. And he kept the pictures of them as babies. So he never, like, forgot about them. Fuck, dude. Oh, this game, man. This game. Okay. Damn, dude. She got out. And her dad helped her get out. Dude, she climbed out of that shit quick. And Jed thinks he killed her. I mean, what is he gonna say? What's he gonna say? We raise our drinks to Jed Lucan. Everything's just a fucking lie. What happened was just a lie. And he's just been living on this lie the entire time to try and cover up what he actually did. And he's in cahoots with fucking Typhon because they're helping him cover it up and he's helping them cover shit. It's fucking shitty, dude. So, I guess I don't know, like, so they think that, I guess this is a rhetorical question. So they think, because maybe it comes up later, but they think, like, the community and the world or whatever think that Jed saved multiple people, but he doesn't, but they don't know that he also let all these other people die, I think. And all these other people, like, that's why Gabe couldn't find a record of his dad, like, of where his dad went. Because they just wiped the records of all of those people. And that's what the fuck, oh, that's what Pike was talking about, too. He was like, yeah, they just kill people off, you know. They just wipe the fucking miners' records. The ones that died. And they just try to shove it all. And this was them trying to bury the evidence of it. So they don't get in any big shit. Yo. Fucking yo.
And during my time here, I've come to realize what makes Haven so special. It's a flower shop run by multiple generations. A bar owner who greets every customer.
Oh, dude, name. Shit's about to get real.
It's a spring festival tradition going back 100 years. History,
dude.
Loyalty.
Jed's face when
pride.
Oh, fuck.
These values which define Haven are the same values that Typhon was built on. And that is why our partnership has been so successful. It's been my privilege to renew Typhon's commitment to Haven. We believe in this community, and we're tremendously excited for its future.
Thank you, Diane.
God, fuck you, Jed.
I think I speak for all of us when I say we're eager to make this official. So, time to vote, folks. And then lunch.
Fuck! Yeah, your face. Yeah, you're about to see a ghost, you asshole. That you thought you murdered. Yeah, fuck you, Jed. Fuck you. Yeah.
Alex, oh my God.
I'm fine.
You are not fine. We have to get you to a doctor.
What happened to you?
This will be hard to hear, dude. Oh, I remember. Oh, fuck.
I found out something you need to hear. I'm sorry.
What?
Alex, you're hurt.
I
you need help, we can call.
Shut up, Diane.
To all of you. And so has Jed Lucan.
Fuck you,
Alex.
Jed.
What's going on?
What's going on? What's going on? You freaking shot at me and I went tumbling down multiple stories into a fucking mine next to a dead rat. That's what's going on here, Jed. Fucking good guy, Jed. Good guy, motherfucking Jed. What's going on? You know what?
Fuck you.
Yes.
What the hell happened?
I was down in the mine last night. I saw what Typhon's been hiding for 12 years.
Yep.
Jed Lucan isn't a hero.
Yep.
That whole story is a lie.
Yep.
Jed caused the accident. And then he abandoned 7 of his men. He let them drown to save himself. There were pictures of me and Gabe down there in the dirt. Because one of those miners was my father. Typhon wanted to keep this covered up in case it jeopardized the vote. All they care about is making more money. They'll do whatever it takes to push this expansion through. So they decided to bury the evidence. And nothing was going to stop that blast. Not even the fact that there were 4 people up in the mountains. That's how Gabe was killed. Jed knew all along. He covered up the truth about the past, about Gabe. And when I found out, as you can see, he tried to kill me too.
You can't get out of this one, Jed. What are you gonna fucking say? What are you gonna fucking say? Pike, what are you gonna arrest the goddamn man, dude?
Why aren't any of you saying anything?
We don't want to embarrass you, Alex.
Oh, what the fuck?
Try me.
These accusations are, well, they're insane.
God.
And trying to go into the mine was obviously a very dangerous, very illegal thing to do.
Oh, are you fucking kidding me?
But we all sympathize with your situation.
Oh my God.
You've been through so much.
Just slap her,
your
dude.
Your brother was your only family, wasn't he? I can only imagine how much you want an explanation for his loss. Something to give you comfort and make your life seem less unfair.
We do know she has a conscience. We do know.
Why don't you just tell the truth? You've been planning your exit from Typhon anyway.
What?
You never signed up for threats or attempted murder. You hate this. Now's your chance to stop.
Dad? Do you have any idea what Alex is talking about?
No. I don't. I've tried to be there for Alex since Gabe died. I thought, I don't know. I hoped I could be something of a father figure to her. All I can guess is, sometimes when we're hurting, the people we lash out at are the ones who were trying to help.
Dude, I want to strangle this fucking guy. You're a monster.
You tried to kill me. How can you stand there and say these things?
Alex.
You're a monster. Please. I know this is hard to accept. You all trust him. I did too. But I'm telling the truth.
I believe you.
Of course I do.
Fuck yeah, Steph.
I believe you too.
Charlotte?
I'm horrified and shocked and still processing everything, but I believe you.
I would like to speak.
Fucking ducky, yes.
This young lady came to Haven as a stranger. But over the last few weeks, she's become one of us. Now, her story certainly seems unlikely, if not impossible. But she deserves at least an investigation of her claims.
Yeah, she does.
We ought to take her seriously.
Yeah, Pike. Grow some balls, Pike. Let's go.
Agree with Ducky.
Eleanor's got the balls.
I've always found Alex to be a very trustworthy person.
Because I didn't tell her. I didn't tell Riley.
She wouldn't make these accusations lightly. Something must have happened.
Yeah, he shot me, dude. He tried to shoot at me.
There's no actual evidence of anything.
Diane, sit down.
Maybe not, but that's what I think.
Yeah, fuck you.
Actually, Diane, there is evidence.
Yes!
For fuck's sake.
I have a USB stick full of recordings.
Yes, Pike.
We went through this yesterday. Your superiors closed the case. None of
well,
us
Well, now
have
it's
time
open
for conspiracies.
Again. Stinky.
Yeah. You're trying to weasel your way out of things again, huh? I know your game.
His courage. He got his courage.
To me, Jason.
Jason.
You know what? I'm not scared of you anymore.
Yes!
And not of you? Not Typhon?
All right, that's enough.
Deputy Pike, do you have some kind of personal issue with me?
Like hell I do.
Jason. Well, given that your judgment in this matter is emotionally compromised, you should probably remove yourself
from... Oh, cut the crap. If you think you could shut me up...
Jason, I think you better cool it. I'd like to speak again.
It concerns me that a voting member of this council has openly admitted to a personal bias that...
This is a load of bullshit.
I don't believe it. Ridiculous.
You believe me. Right?
I'm not your lapdog anymore.
Deputy Pike, I am not responsible for any frustrations you feel in your career.
I know the different... I'm going first thing tomorrow. Shh.
Wait.
Dad. Please. Come clean.
Ooh.
We'll figure it out together.
Ooh.
It amazes me. The extent to which she has manipulated
what?
You.
This guy! Take his
Come
fucking
on,
mustache! Rip it off his face!
Never in a million years.
Come on. I hate seeing you do this.
My own son.
Death.
My own goddamn son!
Oh my god.
Stop.
My, this asshole man. She's got the power. Whoa. Hello? What are we doing here? It's a freaking fly! Get away from me! I don't have time for you, fly.
I know why you tried to kill me. It's not what you tell yourself. That you thought it was best for Haven. This was never about Haven at all, was it? This was about you. I know it's easier not having to think about the men you buried. You want to look away and pretend the people you hurt aren't people. But I won't let you. My father worked for you. His name was John.
This is hard. This isn't even a major decision, but it's still hard. My first instinct is to go with he was a screw up. But I still think he's a fighter as well. And I do think that he also was a victim as well. Oh God, what do I want to do? I think all of these things. Actually, I think I'm going to go with he was a victim. I don't know. Fuck. I'm going to go with my original first gut.
He made a lot of mistakes.
Yeah.
He wasn't a good father. I think he came here trying to be better.
I think so, too. I like that choice.
He killed him. And then Gabe. My big brother. Haven was his second chance. He was so proud of who he'd become. A great boyfriend. A cool dad. But he died. Because of you. And then there's me. For so many years, I just wanted to survive. To get through. Haven changed me. I started to think about the future. I want to belong somewhere. I want to know that there's a place and a group of people who wouldn't be the same without me. I was starting to feel that here. And you tried to murder me. You would have ended my life just so you wouldn't have to face the truth.
Her eyes.
You've forgotten it, haven't you? You've plastered over it with another story. You tell yourself you're a hero, a strong leader. Sometimes that means making hard choices. Decisions that could lead to people dying. Few men could handle that. Haven's lucky to have you. But that's the lie. If you scrape it away, what do we see? Seven years ago, you led a group of men to their deaths. And you were too selfish to say those words out loud. There was so much to lose. The love of your wife. The respect of your son. The comfort and ease you had walking around the world. All of that mattered more to you than those men's lives. I can feel you trying to pull away. Don't.
Looks so good.
The truth hurts. Sometimes it's so awful you think you're gonna break. But when you come out the other side, and you're whole and free and still alive, then you'll finally know how strong you really are. I see the truth about you. You hate yourself. You hate what you did in the past. You hate what you've done to keep it secret. And the more you deny that hatred, the worse it grows.
This is so good, guys. Erica is fucking killing it.
I know who you are. I've seen the worst parts of you.
Damn. What is condemning again? Stupid question. I know we've got some VIPs that are able to talk. Help me. Like, you condemn someone? Disapproval. Okay. Okay. So that's me saying that I'm not okay with what you did. Or I can choose to forgive him. Got it. Okay. Oh! I know this isn't even a big decision, but like, Jesus Christ. Do I want to say I forgive him and try and tap into his psyche a bit and just make him feel more? Or do I want to say I won't forget? Like, I mean, forget, like, that's me. Yeah. Or saying I don't want to forgive you. That just maybe, I don't know. Fuck. My initial gut is to go with forgive, but like, then I think about literally everything. Like the death of my dad, the death of my brother, like but forgiving is important because it allows you to let go of the pain that you've been holding on to. Forgetting and forgiving are two different things. Like, Alex will never forget any of this stuff. She'll never forget what happened to her in her past, you know, with what her dad did. She'll never forget Typhon doing this and her brother dying. But being able to forgive allows her to, over time, let go. So I think I'm gonna say I forgive you for Alex's sake.
And I forgive you.
Yeah. I felt like that was probably gonna tap into some sadness with him. Wow. Wow. I'm getting chills right now. Holy shit. Wow. Holy shit, guys. That scene was, I think, the best. That was the best. And that was, like, that was just, like, Erica doing an incredible job at that monologue. Holy shit. That was so fucking good, guys. Wow. That was incredible. Holy shit. Oh, my God. Dude, chapter 5 is no joke.
And the news is still coming in on the Typhon mining scandal that has rocked the western slope town of Haven Springs. Council meeting was the scene for shocking revelations. Local bar owner and council president Jed Lucan admitted in a tearful confession to covering up the deaths of 7 Typhon employees as their manager 12 years ago. A recent cover-up, which involved a clandestine and unpermitted explosion to thwart and caused the death of Haven local Gabe Chen last month. Mr. Lucan is currently in police custody awaiting arraignment. We will have plenty more about this developing story, including the resignation of Typhon's CEO, the market impact, and what it all means for your drive time commute coming right.
Damn, dude. The CEO resigned. Fucking dick.
Yeah. The silence is worse. I need to get some air.
Oh my god, guys.
After summoning all my strength and willpower, I'm now ready
to play some Mindhunt. We have to chill out, okay? We have to chill out. I have to get on the board. Guys, we just went through a lot of fucking shit. And we'll look at my phone and my text. And we'll deal with it all. But we need to just vibe real quick, okay? Omni, thank you so much for the gifted subs. You're amazing. I appreciate you. No hesitation. I'm telling you guys. I told you, the moment I saw the arcade, we're going into it. Mm-mm. The moment I saw the arcade, we're oh shit. We're playing. Nope. We gotta get it. We gotta get to where we're going, you know? Omni, thank you so much for the gifted subs again. I'll read those out one at a time here when I am able to read Chitty Chat Chat and all the notifications. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. I died. Oh no. Thank you so much again. I appreciate you. Okay. No, I'm not playing one game. We're getting on the board. I'm playing until I get on the fucking board. Okay, I gotta focus. Oh no, not this again. We're getting in there. We're getting there. Again, Omni, I appreciate you so much. Thank you so much for the kind words, and thank you so much for the gifted subs. I appreciate you. I don't know if you're planning on playing True Colors, but if you do, let me know how you like it. Okay. No, we did not finish the game. I'm taking a little mental break here because a lot of crazy stuff has happened. And I need to play Mindhunt. Thank you so much, Narwhal. I need to play Mindhunt. I mean, this isn't like I... The fact that I'm making... The fact that I'm making Alex play Mindhunt after she just was in a mine is kind of fucked up now that I think about it. Not very happy. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Yeah, I guess I didn't really think about that. I kind of feel fucked now. It's gonna be good because we're gonna win. And she's gonna feel better about the entire situation. I just need to get 10th place. I don't even need to get the high score. I just need to beat Ducky. Like, the fact that I can't even beat Ducky. Yeah, first try. I've actually never played this game, like this minecart game before. This is my first time playing it. Oh. My god, it's gonna kill me. What was I supposed to do? Fuck. I need to get this stinky battery. Got him. I needed this distraction, guys. My emotions were all over the place. These stinky ghosts are chasing me. Thank you. Got him. But okay, I just don't know how to beat this one. What do I need to do to not die from this cart? Woo! All right, okay, I'm safe. I don't know, I guess I just had to go. I think you have to go before the other carts start coming. Okay, this is the best I've done. Oh my god. I can't die though. Hold on. Woo! Okay. This is the best I have done. Okay. And we got this. We got like 2,000 more. And the carts, yeah, don't stop coming and they don't start coming. That's true. Oh my god, I'm gonna pass it. No way. Are you serious? Wait, it was up there the entire time? Wait a second. Stop, Katy, stop. No! I didn't know that it was up there! Why did I just die? Katy Bentz! I don't know what happened. I'm pissed. I'm playing again. Shh! Guys, just pretend. Just go, you know. You need to go to the bathroom. You need to go get a snacky snack. You need to do some stretching. Don't worry about it, okay? I was literally right there. I was literally gonna do it, and then I got murdered because I freaking fell, damaged myself. Fall damage. Unbelievable. Oh yeah, baby. No lives lost yet, Katy. Okay. I didn't realize that the thing was up at the top. I thought I had to go back down to the bottom, so that's why I jumped. And then I didn't know what to do. I had missed my cue. Okay, so when I get back to the mine carts, I have to just go. I have to go before they go. That's the only way. Yeah, I can't stop and just chill at that level. Because before I was like, oh, what's the perfect time to go? No, you have to go right away. You have to just jump. There is a rhyme to reason, you know? What am I doing up here? Oh my god, put me here. I can't. Oh god, fuck. Oh fuck. No. Okay, Bentz. Oh my god, you guys. I'm gonna die because I can't survive. Okay, okay, we got it. Could have died, didn't die. What's good? Don't fuck me. What's up, ghost? Get wrecked. Okay. Okay. I'm not trusting. Okay, I think I can only drop one level. If I drop more than one level, then I'm done for. All right. I still have all my lives, too. This is looking good, guys. We're looking great, folks. That always happens where I forget that little corner there. I think last time I didn't get the light. And so I got the corner, like that little last piece of gems that I need. But then I lost a life. Alright. Not messing around here, guys. I got three lives. Triple kill. Alright. We gotta wait for this little stinker to see where he's gonna go. Gotta, you know, fake him out. Let him think, you know? Let him think he's got me. But he has... He does not... Am I gonna die? Fudge. No! It almost looks like I'm not gonna make that little one, you know? Look at this. No lives. No lives lost. Alright, we're back on to the minecart one. And I just gotta jump right away. I just gotta go right away. I gotta go right away. Right after this one. That's the only way to do it. Oh, we gotta get up there. It's the only way. And we gotta just... I'm fucking waiting. Oh, man. Okay, we're here. We got it. 29? Oh, my God. I'm about to get on it. Yeah. You see that, guys? Oh, I'm 500 away from getting in 10th place. Let's go, ducky. Oh, my gosh. I'm stuck. Okay. I got scared. I'm just hanging out on the ladder. But whose butt's clenched right now? Oh. I wasn't supposed to go there. We are going, guys. Oh my God. Okay, I got on the board now. Where does it come? Where does it go? Where does it go? It's right there? Okay. We're going to the oh shit. We're gonna get the high score here. We're going for the high score. If I don't get the high score though, guys, I won't continue playing because I've made it on the board. I just wanted to beat Ducky. That's really what I wanted. This is the run. I haven't died once. Knock on that stinky wood. I haven't been to this one before. This is new territory. I haven't been. I died. It's fine. I just haven't been here before. I have to get up to the other side. Go, little man. Look, I'm fine with getting what place I got, you know? I am honestly fine with my decision. Are you serious right now? Oh my God. Go! I just stayed! I did it! I clicked! You know what? I'm just using my D-pad now. I don't trust the joystick. The joystick screwed me up there. The joystick led me to death. Oh, there's a fly again. What is happening? Why can't I get off right there? I'm mad. Oh, I thought I was gonna die again. I should be able to get off right there. Are you serious? I'm gonna die. I at least got on the scoreboard and I'm happy with my decision of playing and getting on the score. I did not look. Is that Steph? I beat Steph. One of Steph's scores. Okay, we gotta get back to the game, guys. Thank you guys for humoring me. Okay.
Maybe I do deserve some dollar sign justice, but I'd much rather be able to move on with my life. I want to go outside without seeing anyone. That's why the LARP was 2 days ago.
That doesn't seem possible. So the span of all this stuff is crazy. Okay. She still has cuts on her head too. I feel like, I don't know how she's walking, dude.
I love this guitar, but if it starts asking me riddles again, I'm throwing it out the window.
Thank God for that beam that saved her halfway through, or she would
Maybe
be dead.
Maybe Dad deserved everything he got. But I'm still glad we were there with him in his last moments.
Okay, I don't want to cry anymore. Oh, can we zen out? Yay! 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 And she's gonna play guitar. She's gonna feel the vibrations on her belly.
I've been playing a lot the last 2 days, trying to think things through. But I realize it's actually the opposite. When I'm playing is the only time I get to not think. Not think about Jed, or Gabe, or Dad, and what could have been if he'd never come to this town. Most of all, what I don't think about is me, because I've never been good at that. And suddenly, it's the only question that's left. So, I just keep
playing. Beautiful shot. It's just so crazy that, yeah, they're here because Gabe wanted to try and find his dad, and his dad was trying to find work, so he came here. And now she's here because Gabe was like, I'll let you stay with me. Crazy, man. Crazy, crazy, crazy. Just looked up how to get Ryan to support you in the end, and apparently it's pretty difficult, so good job on getting it the first try. Non-rhetorical question, what do you have to do to get Ryan to support you? I'm actually asking. What did you find out, Inventive? No one supported you? Everybody, I think, supported me. I didn't romance him. I romanced Steph. There's a list of 10 items. I got everybody to support me. I did. I had a fucking perfect game. It's incredibly hard to get all four people to support you. And I did it on my first try. Wow. I was supportive. I was supportive of everybody. I helped Ducky. I was trustworthy to Eleanor because I kept her secret from Riley and let her do her thing. I helped Pike with making him feel courageous. Stephanie made out. What did I do with Ryan though? What was the thing I did? And Charlotte, I left Charlotte with her own. Man, how did I do that so perfectly? That means that, okay, not to toot my own horn, but like, that means that I was given this power.
For some fresh air.
I was given this power, but I didn't go too overboard with it. So if Pike and Charlotte support me, then Ryan supports me? I built myself a community. Hey, Mal, how are you doing? Yeah, I was given this power, but like even during my playthrough, I was like, I don't feel right using my power on Charlotte because I felt like that was meddling too much. Like, Charlotte was very clear that she really did not want me there. And the fact that she got so, so mad at me. And, so I was like, I don't feel like it's right for me to meddle in her and take her anger away. So I didn't. But it ended up being okay that I took Ducky's sadness. Man, I guess I really tapped into the character. I don't know. I just really wanted to be, I wanted to be truthful. I wanted Alex to be truthful. I wanted her to be honest and with the new people that she was meeting, like, especially Eleanor, you know? Like, I told Eleanor about Gabe's death, but I also kept this the secret that Eleanor told me, you know? Honest Alex. So Ryan supports me if everyone supports me. Cool. So you don't get... The Pike one's confusing me. So Pike supported me because I gave him courage. I tapped into his. So does Pike support you if you tap into his feelings? If you I think it was his fear he had, right?
Time to head up the stairs.
So I took his fear and that's what tapped it. Okay. Cool. No, that was a real one, Roman. I know they're difficult. I appreciate you. Okay, cool. So if you don't tap in, that's confusing though, because yeah, the only one that gets to support us that we don't tap into is Charlotte. All the other ones we tap into, like Eleanor's was a little bit different because we tapped into her, but we also kept her secret. So you could tap into Eleanor and not keep her secret, and she probably wouldn't support you because she made a point to say that I was trustworthy. And obviously, if we didn't see Ducky. Yeah, so I think with Eleanor, you have to tap into her emotions. Like, you have to. Did the game just pause because I was talking too much? Rude game! So yeah, you have to tap into her feelings, and I think you have to tell her about Gabe. And then keep her secret from Eleanor. You don't tap into Charlotte's anger. Which is so interesting. I mean, personally for me, like, it just felt right not to tap in. It just felt right not to tap in to her feelings. Because she really didn't want me. She really did not want my help. And, you know, I was just trying to really, like, understand that I didn't. Like, she didn't want my help. And I felt like it would have been bad taking her anger. And also, I didn't know what it was going to do to Alex. So I was like, I can't, like, I don't want to use my power and meddle too much. Like, it's not good, you know, it's not good. I think it's what I'm seeing in the chat from some of the devs is that if you have a certain number of people supporting you, then Ryan supports you. Yeah, I don't think you have to have all people. I think you just have to have a certain number of people. Greater than half. So even if you romance him, he still doesn't. Literally everyone but Pike and Ryan said I was lying. That's crazy. That's so cool that I got everybody. I didn't even think about that until you guys mentioned it. Wow. Wow. Thank you guys for letting me know. I feel good. That's so good. I've had some really shitty playthroughs of games in the past, and this is really good. It's good to know that just like my true like feelings of how I wanted to play Alex was like ultimately the best. I'm tooting my own horn, okay? Let me have it. Let me have this. Okay. And also, I'm sorry. You don't get Steph on your side if you make out with her. You get Steph on your side if you also help her. I'm guessing. I didn't really even talk about Steph. I think Steph's always on your side because that's one of your first times tapping into people's emotions. So I think that's kind of inevitable that you're going to tap in. I'm sorry. Oh, man.
Berlin does sound pretty good right about now.
Yeah, Steph supports you no matter what. We stan.
Must be rare that a local paper gets to break out the really big headline.
8 deaths covered up by Typhon Mining.
See? This is why I try to only read the art sections.
Old and new talent shine at Spring Festival. Join together to create musical magic under the Spring Festival stars on Saturday. Alex Chen, who brother gave Chin, longtime bartender of the Black Mist. Why do they have to say that? It's been a long time since I've witnessed a Spring Festival crowd dance together with abandon like that. Local novelist, it was transportive. Mainstay on the Spring Festival stage, held down the drums. That was so fun. Haven will survive. Fought dream demons in the past. We know that this typhon mining scandal will leave a unique scar in the psyche of our small town, not just from what took place, horrible enough as the details are, but from what was involved. A young and beloved bartender, a respected mining industry, up-and-comer, and the town's most revered patriarch at the center of it all. Currently sits in the San Miguel County Prison. He is said to be fully cooperative with the police and repentant of his actions. But the harm he has done to this town, to all of us who knew and trusted him over the years, is just beginning to be understood. Still, in the face of this tremendous calamity, we say Haven will survive. We will. Oh, man. Can I just put the fucking puzzle piece? Where is it? Where is that puzzle? Are you underneath the fridge? This entire game. Where's that puzzle piece? Rhetorical. If actually we can put a puzzle piece in there. Okay. I have an idea. Okay, wait. I have an idea. I think we will hopefully find that puzzle piece. Because every time I unlock memories, there's like the little thing, the little like unlocking memory like gif is Alex's brain being put back together with puzzle pieces. I have to find the piece of this puzzle somewhere to complete this game fully. That's it. I figured it out. Okay. I actually need to check some stuff. Okay, I was too busy playing Mine Hunt. I'm not going back to play, but I did see Glormax say something about it. I'm not going to play it. Don't worry, guys. I'm not going to play it again. But there was something in the main screen that Glormax wanted me to see. Tapping into the Matrix. What did you want me to see, Glormax? Oh, yes. Go look. Oh, that it says Idle Minds? Yeah. This is actually made completely from Deck 9. So, they were saying that the CEO made it, and then there are other cinematic or other animators, I think, and program devs that actually had different levels of the game as well. If any of the devs are in the chat right now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that is what I was told. Yes, CEO, yes. Mark! Mark is really great. Mark is who emailed me about reprising my role. Pretty cool. Pretty freaking cool. Yes. Yes, that is true, Glormax. Thank you, AP. Yeah. Yeah, so that's just a completely, like, developed game from top to bottom. Completely new game right there. Pretty cool. Okay, let's see some stuff.
I'm glad he held on to it for whatever it's worth.
Oh, wow. They told me to destroy this jacket after the accident. I couldn't do it. Perhaps some part of me knew that one day need... But wait, hold on. Some part of me knew that I would one day need to pass it along. When Gabe first stepped into my bar looking for his father, I swore I would one day return this jacket to him. Then I swore I would return it to both of you. I think you know by now that my word is worth. I did not deserve your forgiveness, but it moved me more than I knew was possible. I hope this gift will provide some small comfort to you in the days ahead. Damn. So this jacket was the father's. Fuck.
You ever swing a pick before, Mr.
Chen?
It literally says Chen on it.
But I'm a hard worker. And I learn fast, and I don't mind long hours.
You don't have somebody waiting on you at home?
No, sir.
Well, John, guess you're a hell diver now.
Chad must have thought he was seeing a ghost the first time Gabe walked in.
Damn. Jet Alex. I got good at describing other people's emotions in this book, even new emotions, complicated ones. I could push through the mystery, find the words, but I don't know if I can do that here. I know that something is more, something in me resonated with something in Jed, each hooking into the other, drawing us together. I saw it in him, and it was like walking into a house you used to live in, seeing what someone else has done to it. Blazing self-hatred, so bright you can't let yourself look at it. The sure knowledge that you spread rot to everything you touch. The rigid feeling of the role, the routine, the lines you memorize and regurgitate to keep yourself from succumbing to the pool and looking at the truth. Maybe that's why I forgave him for all of this. The heat and the force of his loathing required me to face my own. Like two magnets of the same polarization, pressing each other backward. The bullet, the fall, the hospital, the house, the orphanage. Is it weird that I feel grateful for them? Grateful to Jed for giving them to me? For however accidentally pushing me to look at my own self-hatred and come out on the other side. Side B. It all makes sense. Fill your hands with grains of sand and the rocks you see, the clocks. Thought I could hurt, I could be brave. Nothing can save you, nothing to save. Of times that pass, the good, the bad, your life's a life you'll wish you had. Damn. I'm so sad. I've missed so many little memories. And we gotta get them back at some point. We gotta get them. Okay. For most of my life, I've known what other people were feeling, couldn't escape it. Sometimes it felt like I was drowning, flailing to keep my head above water and sinking anyway. And all that time, the only person whose feelings I really wanted to understand was you, Dad. And then I found you at the bottom of the world, and I finally felt you were feeling. And that's what messed up is. Your emotions were just so normal. Human, I guess. Fear, regret, same stuff as everyone else, same stuff I've been drowning in since I was a kid. Shouldn't take an empath to know that, but I think I needed to feel it before I could let it go. And now the only person whose feelings I still need to understand is me. Damn. I wonder who he would have been if things had been different. John. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. John. Or John, husband or widower, dad or whatever he decided to be instead. What if Mom hadn't died? What if they'd never come to the States? What if Gabe and I hadn't come along? Would things be different? Or was there something about him? Something impossibly, bottomlessly sad that was always going to lead him here or someplace like here. He didn't have somebody waiting for him at home. He was right. We had already been plucked up and sent away, isolated from him, each other, ourselves. He thought a lot about coming back someday, whether he was strong enough, whether he'd be doing more harm than good. I don't know. I know it would have been nice to look at him in the eyes as an adult and get to decide how I feel about him. It's hard to forgive a ghost. Damn. June. Chinjun. Like that, Chinjun. Damn. Oh, man. Wow, all the texts. Jin. Chinjun. Jessica. Rocky Mountain Gazette, I'm sorry to contact you out of the blue. I know we've been through a lot. We were working on a story about Typhon controversy, and I'd love to speak with you either on or off record about your experience. I'm not really comfortable talking about it now. Your comfort would be my priority. Please contact me at this number if you change your mind. Okay. Too soon. Hey, come meet me at the rooftop. Sure thing. Alex, you're incredible, and I'm here for you no matter what. Call me the minute you need anything. I know. Thank you for having my back. It means so much, of course. How could I not after everything? Growing up, my dad was my hero, and after the accident, he was the whole town's hero. It was the best feeling in the world to know others saw him the way I did, and no one questioned it. Even when the strange phone calls started, the late nights, locking his office when he left the house. But it was all lies. And now I know the truth, because you showed it to us. Let me know if you need help. I'm here. Thank you, Ryan. I will. Oh, hey, Chen. Didn't think you'd actually take down Typhon. You're braver than I ever imagined. Now you owe me a new job. I'm glad you're okay, really. Hey, thanks, Mac. Dear Alex, you've been through an awful lot these past few weeks, but your resilience and courage continue to astound me. I have no doubt that you will weather this affront against your person with the same grace as you demonstrated to me during our lovely dance at the Spring Festival, a moment I will not soon forget. So please remember that we are here for you. Sincerely, Reginald McAllister III. I know, and I appreciate you sticking up for me, Ducky. I don't even know what to say, Alex. My heart breaks for what you have endured. No one should have to live through that. But just remember that Ethan and I are here for you. Thanks, Char. What you did wasn't easy. I won't forget it. I heard what happened. Oh my god, I heard what happened. You weren't going to mention me being a superhero when I texted yesterday. I'm so glad you're safe. Thanks, buddy. Aww. You look great. Aww. Arthur. The New York Telegram. We want your story in our ongoing Typhon coverage. When is a good time? We want it. What the fuck, asshole? I'm not doing any media right now. Getting a lot of requests. When did you learn that your father lived? Oh my god. Worked with Judd Lucan. How did it feel to learn that Judd Lucan was responsible for it? What? She said no. What an asshole. Oh man. Alex, please pick up. Just let us know you're okay as soon as you can. I'm sure you just lost your phone, but Ryan's freaking out. We're both freaking out. We just want to make sure you're safe. Jed was literally, they had a whole thing to say that Alex went into the mine to just, like, hunt things down. And if she died, that's how she died. She just went down there by herself because she talked with Jed that night. And Jed, everyone's going to believe Jed because he's such a great person. He's broken, too. Everybody's broken. Everyone's broken. What Jed did is definitely the worst of it all, though, but fuck. Yeah, I mean, she called it. Alex called it out, you know? He was selfish and couldn't come to, you know, forward to it, but... Man, okay.
I bet Steph wishes she could reword that, but it's pretty funny.
I'm writing an article about the evening's incredible performance at the Spring Festival, but I can't track down the band's name. Anybody know? Hey, man, so we aren't like a band as such, so we don't really have a name yet. Can I get your names for the article? I'm Steph Gingrich, the brains of the operation. My muscle's Alex. She's going to die when she sees this.
I'm so sorry. I worried you all.
Anybody to see an Alex today? We agreed to meet up last night, but then she ghosted. Super not like her, kind of freaking out. Called a cell, no response. That's troubling. Haven't seen her. Keep me posted, will you? Little charade. We'll not be open today for lunch on account of the town council vote. We'll see you for a happy hour. So she was there all night long. She was there all night long in the mines. Making last night's Spring Festival such a resounding success. Now comes another annual tradition, cleaning up after ourselves. We'll need volunteers to help. Drop your name in the hat. Oh, pish. I like Eleanor.
It never ends.
A statement regarding the ongoing investigation in Haven Springs. We appreciate the community's concerns. Details are still emerging, and we are cooperating with the state police. We currently have exactly as much information as any of you. State police have tapped Deputy Jason Pike to provide assistance in the case, and as such, management of this account has been handed over to another deputy. While we acknowledge that Deputy Pike has come to occupy a special role in Haven Springs community, we urge you to direct all inquiries through official channels. Happen under your noses. What is going on? What is going on over there? No way the cops didn't know. They did know.
The phrase recent events is doing some work in this post. I've got some continued support for you.
I'd like to express our gratitude toward Haven Springs for your continued support. Shut up, Typhon.
Do I need a Charlotte Harmon portrait?
I've decided to open back up for commissions. I think we're looking for ways to stay busy right now. So please get in touch if you want a portrait. I try to keep my rates reasonable. Record Traders is currently accepting applications. Priority will be shown to applicants with previous retail broadcast experience. Fill out an application on our website. We'll be conducting interviews next week. I'm deaf applying if you're hiring 16-year-olds. But is there like a sudden opening? Who left? Nobody just yet. But to be honest, I'm kind of eyeing the exit. Looking for new adventures. Aw. Okay. Wait, did I see literally everything I needed to see? Okay. Thank you guys for hanging with me and being patient. I feel like we're close to the end, and then I'm going to sit here, and I know I haven't looked at notifications for a hot second. I'm going to sit here and go through all the notifications very soon to thank you guys for everything. I appreciate you all being here.
I'll never understand exactly what happened to me down there, but I'll always be grateful.
I know, it's like, was that her subconscious, or, you know, was that actually the ghost of Gabe? You know? Play interview.
Now that my inaction in the face of injustice was itself a terrible wrong. And I know that I will never be able to undo the tremendous pain and loss I caused. I do not ask for forgiveness.
Damn.
The only person who could give that to me is gone. Thank you.
There are no victories at the end of this.
An email? I don't have emails. Are you talking about the lathe flower? Spring festival?
Just
dude, that's fucked up.
Good thing I sold off all my Typhon stock.
Is that what you're talking about, Elsa? Oh, okay. Hours after a press conference in which he vowed to accompany choppy waters ahead. Oh yeah, the CEO resigned.
I'm pretty sure my voice was already heard by everyone who needed to hear it. Is it weird that the part of this that bothers me the most is nondescript dive bar?
Damn. Murder. Criminal fraud. In the room, a great man was made to stand naked before all. Huh. Interesting. They all just saw it happen. Okay. Making sure I'm not missing anything.
Even though it was hard, I'm glad I let Charlotte overcome her own anger.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Gave her the strength to support me.
That's the thing, yeah. We allowed her to overcome her own anger instead of taking it away from her.
I felt very close to Ducky after our dance.
We gotta feel our own feels sometimes.
I guess he felt the same way.
Crutches.
This air was powered by adrenaline that whole morning. Now I'm mostly powered by extra strength Advil. And these.
I go back to the dresser to see if I can change my outfit. I'm addicted. I think I'm good. I don't think there's any... Hopefully nothing else. Okay. Let's go shopping. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Hey, Steph.
It's Steph!
Alice, wait. Before you say anything, I have to get this out.
Oh.
Okay.
What you did at the council meeting, it was the bravest thing I've ever seen. And it made me want to be brave, too. So, here it goes. I want to be with you. I don't give a shit about playing music or seeing the world. I mean, I do, but only if it's with you. And if you'd rather stay here instead, then... Fuck it. I want to stay here, too.
You ripped your bus ticket.
I can get another one. Or not. It doesn't matter. Point is, I'm in. For whatever you want.
You've, given me a lot to think about.
Well, good. That was the idea. You know where to find me. Good luck, Chen.
Thanks, Steph.
Oh, they're so cute. She ripped her ticket for her. She professed her love for her. They're so cute. Oh, it looks so good. The lighting is so pretty.
All right. Just tell me.
Oh.
What?
My future.
Aw.
What to do? Aww. The night of the Spring Fest, Steph made a strong push for leaving with her. Playing on the road. The excitement of the unknown.
Oh, I don't know what to do.
Of course. That was before all the shit went down. Come on, you're the know-it-all. So tell me.
Ooh.
Actually, I do know what you should do. You should stay in Haven.
You really think so?
Of course. You finally have a home, a job, people who actually like you. Why would you give that up?
That's true.
Ooh.
Then again, maybe leaving would be better.
Aw, I don't know what to do.
What?
You're young, you suddenly have a little money, friends. And don't you think it's time to give this music thing a real shot? No, you should definitely leave.
Oh, fuck off.
I like how they have the same smile.
I don't need the mysterious spirit bullshit right now. I just need my big brother.
I'm sorry.
I know.
The glass is moving. It's cute.
But here's something. It's 3 hours from now. A bus pulls away. You're not on it. And neither is Steph.
Life goes on.
Was that my ending? I like
you
it.
You get a job working with Steph at the record store.
I love it. I love this. Yes, this is what I wanted. This is what I wanted.
All those years of being a music snob finally pay off. And little by little, time does its thing.
Aww. Oh, I love that. I love that transition. Oh, yay.
The apartment starts to feel less like a museum, more like a home.
And we still have our shrine for him. Don't give up. I love that Gabe is narrating this.
Lots of Jed.
Perfect.
Of Typhon. Even of me. Begin to fade into the background.
Community run establishment. I like it. I like it. Riley and Charlotte both met new people. Ah. Eleanor. Eleanor. Yes. Nat 20, baby. Oh. Ooh. Spicy.
Rooftop is your stage. You perform every week to a small but adoring group of fans.
Oh. Steph!
Maybe while you
play,
you wonder what could have been. Performing for more people in more cities, sharing your music with the world. Or maybe you never think about that much at all.
I love my ending. It's perfect. I love it.
You don't know exactly when it happens, but one day you look around and find that you have transformed this place just as much as it has transformed you. And the most extraordinary thing of all is just how normal it feels. You don't question it. You don't doubt it. Or wonder what might have been. It's your life. The life you fought so hard to have. And for the first time in a long time, you just live.
Mm.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
You really think I'll transform Haven?
Of course. You already have. With your gift, your music, just by being you. But Alex, that doesn't mean you have to stay. You have the potential to do that anywhere you go.
Oh, I still have to make a choice. I have to make a choice still, but that was so perfect, Gabe. Please narrate the rest of my life, thank you.
Where am I supposed to go? I don't have any other home.
That is true. But you didn't have any home before coming here. And look what happened. The truth is, there's no telling what that version of your future might be. The only promise is the adventure.
That's a great line. That's a great line. God, these writers.
What do you think?
They just showed me my life in Haven. Why would I not want that? Why would I not want to just go with what they just showed me? That was beautiful. Yo, what the fuck? I have to stay in Haven. I have to. What they just showed me was beautiful. But I do understand. I understand the decision, you know? Like, I know. Here's the thing. Let's have a little talksy here, okay? Here's the thing. So, we know what our life in Haven's gonna be like. Some people can say this is the ghost of Gabe, or some people can say that it's Alex's subconscious. I think for me personally, in this situation, it makes sense that it's Alex's subconscious, because she knows what her life is gonna be like here in Haven Springs if she stays. She knows exactly what it's gonna be like, and that's comforting to her, obviously, in those memories or those foreshadowing of like what her future is going to be. Like, that's comforting her, and that's comforting for a lot of people to know exactly how something's going to go. But also, on the other side of things, you have the unknown, which is seeking adventure, and a lot of people can be really scared of the unknown, especially when you have this comfort of a place you finally found with people who finally accept you. And so the unknown can be really, really scary. But I feel like at this point, you know, Alex she's ready, and like, she could jump into the unknown if she wanted to. Like, she could take on literally anything. Like, she has proven it to herself that, you know, I'm sure she's still working through her emotions and things, but she's come a hell of a long way from before she came to Haven, obviously, from all those texts we've seen between her and the people she was crashing on couches with. And I think that she, if she wanted to, she could jump into the unknown and be so fine with it. And Haven Springs will always be here. That's something, you know, too, is like, Haven Springs will always be here. So whether we choose adventure or not, Haven Springs is always going to be here. So we could choose adventure, go travel the world, and then come back to Haven Springs later. We could do that. We could. And Steph said that she would stay or go with me, so that's not an issue, and I hope that doesn't change. I don't think it does. So Steph stays with me. Steph stays with me no matter fucking what. So yeah, I don't know! I love that. I think subconsciously she knows that she's gonna have a great home here, and it's going to be comforting and things. She does not know what the thrill of the adventure is, but I think too, you know, stepping away from everything and getting a breath of fresh air and coming back, you know, and I mean, I don't know how long it's been since all this shit happened. No, it hasn't been long. It's been 2 days. I was in Gabe's little fucking foreshadowing of her future. I was like, wait, we were playing games with Ethan. That was like if she stayed. So it's been 2 days. Guys, we're talking about it, okay? It has been two days. She stays here eventually. Yes, she might get to that point. But like, maybe it's good for her to get out. Maybe it's good for her just to like, yeah, I'm analyzing the shit out of it. It might be good for her to get out and step away from this entire thing, this entire last month and a half, I think, of her life, and take a breather, and she can always come back. That's a good thing too, guys. You can always take one path, and if that path isn't working for you, you can always turn back around and go back on the other path that you were on. You can always go back. You move somewhere, you hate it. You can always go back. I think we're gonna fucking seek some adventure. I think we're gonna seek some adventure, my guy. Let's go seek some fucking adventure. Steph better fucking come with us or I'm gonna cry my freaking eyes out. Because we can always come back to, we can always come back to Haven. We can always come back to Haven Springs. We have to go out. I'm talking up myself. I'm talking myself up because I still am like, it's that comfort. I'm thinking like that comfort. We love comfort. But we know we need to seek adventure. And we've got the love of my fucking life with me. We're doing it. We're seeking adventure. We're seeking adventure. And then we'll come back to Haven Springs later. That's what happens in my game. In my future of these characters, they come back to Haven afterwards. I'm telling myself that. Okay? I hope I like this one. I'm scared because he made it look so good. Oh, wait. Okay. I just gotta like... Ah! Okay. Dude, these decisions are so hard, guys. They're so hard. You guys don't understand how hard they are for me. And this is a big decision. I mean, I feel like I made both the decisions very valid. God, her scene in Haven looked like fun as fuck, though. Wait a second. Ugh, I had another thought. Okay, so her leaving, in a sense, is her thinking about herself and what maybe she needs. Because I was thinking, I was like, well, if we leave all these amazing people, you know, that we could be better friends with, we could, you know, create more relationships with, you know, and maybe that is what Alex needs, but maybe this is what fucking Alex needs, you know? Is she gonna stay just for, you know, the people around her? Is she gonna do what she needs? But is that selfish? But I don't think so, because she's been helping so many people. Oh my god. Hot take. Spicy. Okay. Fuck. My first initial gut was stay in Haven. That's always I always go with my initial gut. I'm gonna play this game again, so I'll choose the other one afterwards. Okay, let's go with Seek Adventure. Oh, but this one, I hope this is a good idea. I hope this is a good decision. Okay, I'm asking, non-rhetorical mods, it's okay. Love in the chat with your emotes if you guys think this is a good idea. And it's okay, I'm asking. I'm gonna do it regardless. We get in love. That's not cheating. What? No, I'm doing it regardless. I love the love. Okay, cool. Yay, okay. I was gonna do it regardless. You don't need our approval. I know, but I just wanted you guys to feel a part of it, you know? Okay, let's go. She's gonna seek adventure. Thank you guys for listening to me on my tangent of trying to make a decision and life is strange. I hope Steph comes with us.
I know what I want.
And he's gone. I'm okay. I don't know if I'm happy with my decision, but you know, I made it. She knows what she wants. She did it. She said it. She knows what she wants. I'm fine. Ryan? Oh dear. What was that? Where's Steph? Where the fuck's Steph? Where the hell's Steph? Oh, the entire town! And by the entire town, I mean my close friends. They feel like the entire town. Come on, Steph, get on the bus. Let's go. Oh, I kind of feel shitty. I did leave Ryan. Fuck. I didn't think about Ryan. It didn't show Ryan in my fucking happy ass stay in Haven. So I kind of forgot about him. They didn't show him in my happy haven stay. Gabe didn't talk about him in there. He wasn't there with me at all. Or was he? Oh shit, we get to experience her actually having adventures. She's got a text message. Where is she? It's Steph. Fuck him up, babe. I love it. I love it. Look at this. They haven't had to text for like a month and a half because they've been with each other. That's fucking cute. That's cute as fuck. Okay. Everything's... I'm not even in Haven anymore. There's no more. Okay. Ah! The glow of the light, too, like on her face and her teeth was really pretty. Okay. Yes! Oh, she's got a picture of all the folks. I feel bad that Ryan's not there, though.
Hello, everyone. I'm Alex Chen.
Yeah, you are. Yes! Ah! I can't believe it's over. I can't believe it's over. Fill your hands with grains of sand. There's Chad, guys. Chad, he hung out with us in chat. We got all the other animators. Look at all these wonderful animators. Amazing. There's Gigi. I love seeing all the names of these folks so much. This makes me so happy. I'm so happy that I was able to be a part of this game. So many amazing people worked on this game, guys. And Chuck's awesome. There's Matt. Esperanto. Matt. Oh man. Nick. It hurts to think of what's to come. We got Kara. We love to see it. All the other cinematic artists. I'll meet you in the sleepless garden. Close your eyes and see a future you. Oh, Chris, I love it. Zach, I absolutely loved working with Zach. Fucking Webb, Caitlin, Toby, these people I spent like all my time with. Corwin, I fucking love Corwin. Corwin's fucking amazing. And Jonathan, all the writers, the writing team, guys, my fucking god. Jonathan, Felice, Ryan, Mallory, Deandra, everybody's fucking amazing. All these wonderful people. I'm sad I didn't get to meet literally all these people. I wish I could have met every single person because everybody shared such a special part in this. Rebecca, hell yeah. All the programmers. There's Nick. I love this. The QAs, hell yeah.
Take on every way. and think that I'm better off all by myself, even if I sink. But you found me and you helped me see the light, the dim fluorescent flicker in a dark, defeated night.
Police headlines.
I've had my fair share of losing, and I've hung on by a thread. Within meaning and the memories, gained friends and wrote some melodies in the darkness. I just couldn't look ahead. I was blinded by my own self-doubt and forgot what I was all about.
Oh, the management team, Jeff. Jeff was the one that messaged me. Jeff was the one that emailed me about the return of Steph. All these wonderful people. Production babies. I love that. Damn. What an intense picture there. Holy shit.
For a long time, I kept my heart closed. Thought it easier to handle it if I was on my own.
Oh, Trinity!
Some things are worth the risk. Nothing comes too easily when joy is dangerous. Share of losing, and I've hung on by a thread within meaning, and the memories gained friends and wrote some melodies in the darkness. I just couldn't look ahead. I was blinded by my own self-doubt and forgot what I was all about.
All these wonderful people. Yes, Square Enix, let's go! Square Enix! All these wonderful people. There's Lucy. Oh.
Nothing comes too easily when joy is dangerous.
I'm telling you guys, aw, Nell is so nice too. I'm telling you guys, it takes an army. Oh, this song now. It takes an army, as you guys can see. Takes an army, not only on the actual development team, but the brand team, the brand side of things, the distribution team. Takes so many people to not only create a game, but to get a great game out there to you guys, you know? And then all the translations, that's a whole nother ball game. God, it's so cool. I don't know if I'll do anything cooler than this. This is the coolest thing that I've ever done. And I'm just so grateful of it. Damn, guys. Okay, the screen is like going because you know when you ever play Guitar Hero and then you look away and everything's like moving? That's what's happening because I was watching it for so long. Oh my gosh, Nancor. Thank you so much for the 10 gifted subs. I need to go through. Oh my gosh, I think this is the most amount of subs I've ever had. Holy shit, you guys. Thank you guys so much. What the fuck? I appreciate you guys. I'm going to go through, like I said, and read all the notifications individually. I do want to look at the stats, though. And then we're going to talk. We're just going to talk. Nancor, thank you so much. Okay. Wow, so the majority stayed in Haven Springs. Listen, I like, a part of me wishes I had stayed in Haven Springs, actually. Oh, I should have went with my gut. It's okay, though, because I'm going to play again. It's fine. It's not real. I got to tell myself. But music was sacred to her, and it was something that allowed her to, you know, get away from everything for a bit. And they're going to come back and live in... They're going to come back and live in Haven Springs again. It's fine. It's fine. Yeah, I don't know. I'm going to stay on my next one. Oh, man. Wow. Most people accepted Jed's actions. Not to fear her emotions. Yeah. 4% were like, I don't care about shit. What? Oh my god. You guys, okay. I have to, this is an incredible hype train. Holy shit. Graham, thank you so much. I'm going to personally go through and thank you all again. Holy shit. Thank you for the 25,000. Holy shit bits. My god. Thank you. Give me a second, guys, and I will read through all of them. I appreciate you all so much. Everyone on the council supported Alex. 11%. Wow. Some members of the council stood up for Alex. None of the council members backed Alex. That means you really fucked up. Wow. Alex wanted to belong somewhere in the future. I mean, I think she belongs somewhere. Fuck, she should have stayed in Haven. Oh, well, it's fine. I'm having anxiety about it now. Alex took a moment to reflect in the apartment. Every time. Ryan stood by Alex during the vote. Alex didn't see Ryan after the vote. Alex forgave Ryan for not believing her. Alex didn't see Ryan after the vote. So he, like, walked away. Alex wasn't ready to forgive Ryan. Alex didn't see Ryan after the vote. I wonder what that one is. Charlotte sided with Alex during the vote. Charlotte believed Alex but couldn't help. Huh. Eleanor sided with Alex. Pike sided with Alex. Ducky sided with Alex. Ryan believed Alex during the vote. Damn. Ryan and Alex don't get together. Steph and Alex leave Haven together. That's all. It's a very split vote, yeah. Steph stays in Haven to be with Alex. Steph and Alex don't get together. Oh, so you can be together with Ryan in Haven or leave with him too. Damn, guys. Oh, my feels. My freaking feels. Okay, I gotta thank some folks because, wait. In 2 weeks, guys, there's something else releasing, and that is Wavelinks, which is the DLC of this game that we just played. So I would like to watch the trailer with you guys of Wavelinks. to get not only me excited, but to get all of you all excited, okay? Okay, we're gonna watch it. We're gonna watch it together. I love this trailer. It is so good. It is so good. Okay. Are you guys excited for Wavelengths? I hope you are. I hope you are. I hope you're excited for Wavelengths. This is Wavelengths DLC. This is Steph's story before Alex comes to Haven Springs.
Steph, Gingrich? Is that how you say it?
Yeah, that's right.
Your friend did tell me you were overqualified for this job.
I think I'll love it. I keep
my hands on myself. What kinds of radio have you done before?
God, let's see. What haven't I done?
So you know your way around an audio booth.
Yeah, totally.
Part of your responsibilities would be managing the record store. I'm sure that won't be a problem.
Oh, right. Yeah, no problem at all. Sorry, computer DJ. It's my turn now. What's up, Kind Haven listeners? Steph here.
Today is the last day of June, and that means we've got one more day to celebrate Pride. Citizens of Haven, do not touch those dials. I have a jam-packed show for you, going all night long.
Nailed it. Happy New Year. You're on with Steph.
I've been meaning to fill out my dating app profile. This is your life. Come on, let's keep playing.
Damn right.
So your friend said you quit your band to be here. Can I ask why?
I'm just trying to, you know, do something cool. Something I can really get into.
Woo! We got some more stuff to look forward to, guys. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for watching the playthroughs. If you watched all five of the chapters, thank you so much. If you just picked and choose, if you just watched this one, I just really appreciate you guys checking these playthroughs and experiencing whatever you experienced with me. And I hope that you really, really enjoyed it. It means the world to me that you guys wanted to experience my playthrough. And obviously this one was a lot for me. Chapter 5 was my favorite one, and it was the one where I was very emotional. It just really hit me in the feels, as I know it did for a lot of other people too. So just thank you so much for watching that with me and experiencing that with me. I really appreciate it. And I just appreciate you all. I've been reading all of your guys' comments on the previous videos, and I'm going to get through there and I'm going to go and respond to some people, like the comments, all of that stuff that I've been doing. And yeah, I just appreciate all the kind things you guys have been saying, and I'm glad to see that you guys have been enjoying them. And I cannot wait for September 30th, the release of the DLC of Life is Strange True Colors, which is Wavelengths, starring Steph Gingrich. I'm going to be playing it on my Twitch channel at twitch.tv/KatyBentz. You can find that link in my description of this video. I'll be playing that on October 1st on my stream. So I'm going to give people a day, hopefully, to be able to play the game. And if you are not able to be there at the live stream, I'll be posting my playthrough here on YouTube again for you all. I'm just, again, really appreciative of you guys wanting to spend time with me and all the kind things you guys have been saying on Twitter and Instagram and YouTube and Twitch. You guys are amazing. You guys warm my heart. And again, this whole last week has just been something that I never could have imagined myself to be experiencing. So thank you again so much from the bottom of my heart for all your support and love and kindness. And yeah. All right, guys. Thank you again so much. Bye.